got an old car and you wish you had some of this newfangled technology that these kids today are playing with. Perhaps Nanda's going to be able to help us with this. I'm with David Vesprami, and he's going to tell us about all this Zeus connected car kit they've got.
Well, I certainly hope we can help. That's the whole idea. What we realize is a lot of late model car functions don't have to be embedded by the manufacturer. We can offer them as smart accessories that can be modular in nature, so people can add them as they go. The first product that we brought on the market is this one right here, which is a phone charger on the surface. It still works great as a phone charger. It charges phones twice as fast as conventional, but it'll also log mileage.
Hold on. This is audio and video. So this is a, it goes into the, let me call it a cigarette lighter, whatever they call that.
That's
port
right.
These days.
Right. So it'll go straight into your 12-volt cigarette lighter. And then with this, it's got constant power. So it knows when you've parked the car, and it will log that in GPS and guide you back to the car after you've parked it. So now not only has it charged your phone, but it's a car locator. It'll send you an update to remind you when your parking meter is going to expire.
So this has GPS in it itself?
No, your phone does. So we use the smartest computer in your car, which is the phone in your pocket, and it's using your phone's GPS. So what happens is when the power is cut to this, it knows that the car is parked. It sends a signal to your phone saying, remember this location.
Oh, I see.
And then your phone will be able to guide you back to your car.
Okay, and the way it knows the GPS is it's using the GPS in the phone, but you're saying the start and stop is because of whether there's power to
that
device.
Whether there's power to it or not.
Okay, I got you.
And then it's also, because it's got constant power going to it, it'll log that power and tell you if there's a degradation problem with the battery in your car. So over time,
because it's plugged into the battery of your car.
Exactly, yeah. So you can see over time how your battery health is doing.
Okay, so he's got an iPad here showing the battery health and with a nice little graph, okay?
Yep.
All right, so that's just the first simple piece, but that's
a simple piece.
Is that kind of the foundation?
This is the foundation. This is what we were in market with, $29, available globally.
$29, okay.
We've shipped close to 400,000 of these.
Okay.
We also have a key finder, a similar idea that uses Bluetooth to find your keys. It's also got a shutter trigger for your cell phone.
Okay,
that's what the button is.
So that little tether is would be like a tracker or one of those kind of things, but it's just part of the same system?
It's the same basic philosophy, and then the carbon Kevlar cable. And then what we're showing here at CES, it's really exciting, is we've now built a whole family of products that all work through a common app experience. So for the first time now, we have tire pressure monitoring devices that don't actually have to have a tire dismounted. They just simply screw onto the valve stem.
So how does it tell the tire pressure from the valve stem?
Well, what it's doing is it's, and let me go back to it. So you can see right here, it's giving you a visual to let you know that the pressure at the valve stem on that tire is lower than the pressure at the other tires.
But how does it know it from the valve stem?
Because there's constant pressure going to it, and it's got a battery on board, so it's monitoring that pressure. It's a pressure sensor, and then it's sending via Bluetooth an update to your car to let you know when the signal's showing that it's below the threshold.
I'm making a little doubtful face for the audio listeners here, just letting them know. I thought that the sensors that we have in the more modern cars, they have to go through the metal wall to get to the inside cavity in order to measure the tire pressure.
Correct. But if you think about how a tire pressure gauge works that you would put on the valve stem, it works on the exact same principle as that.
So you're actually pressing that valve stem in?
Yes, but it's sealed, so it's not releasing the pressure.
I see what you're saying. Okay, that's pretty
interesting. Doubtful face hopefully goes away with that.
Yeah, I think you brought me along a little bit there.
Good.
So you buy four of these, you just put them on your tires,
you screw them right on. You don't need a wheel and tire shop to do it for you, which is excellent. And then the same thing on the backup sensor. There's nothing hardwired into the car. It's all self-contained.
So what is your backup sensor? How's this work?
So basically, and I'll show you right here on the screen, what it's doing is it's giving you both an audible and a visual alert as you're backing up how close you're getting to objects.
So what he's got here is a license plate, and there's a just a plate down below, a little bar, looks like a sound bar basically underneath your license plate. So that has
proximity sensors.
Okay.
Correct.
So not a camera, but just a
camera. And I could actually tell you just personally, anecdotally, that I did a camera system on my car before I was involved with Nanda. Not only was it something like 8 times the cost of this, but the minute it rains, you get water on the lens and it's worthless. At least with this thing, it's immune to rain, right?
Okay. So what's the angle of the cone that this can see?
I can't tell you the exact sweep angle because I don't know that it's been defined yet. This is still in prototype stage. But I can tell you the price-wise, we're looking at about $100 for this whole unit. And that's also about the same price point, by the way, for the tire pressure monitor sensors, which is considerable savings over the alternatives.
Okay, make that cone be big enough to pick up little kids on tricycles.
I have two little kids, so it's very near and dear
Testers.
To my heart.
Yeah. Come on, honey, ride your truck behind me right now.
Exactly.
I'm going to test this for work.
Maybe the neighbor's kid.
Yeah, there you go. They're not that cute anyway. All right, so the company is Nonda, N-O-N-D-A, and the website is at?
It's Nonda.co, so N-O-N-D-A.co.
Very good. Thank you very much for your time.
Thanks so much for having me.